Now I request Arun Das to present his talk.
Thanks a lot, Ashwin. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So I am Arun Das. I work as a lead engineer in Kaleyra. Kaleyra is a CPaaS company. So I'm going to talk about a project that we have in our company, which actually use Django along with AWS Lambda. So first thing about Django, I don't think that we need an actual introduction to Django. So Django is one of the most used Python web framework along with Flask and Fast API. So developing Django is, as a Python developer, everyone will know how to develop Django projects. But the question is, how do we deploy it? Or how can we deploy the application and scale the application and considering the cost, right? So we have options like Heroku, we have options like AWS, and we have many other, we can deploy the application in EC2. But the important question is how we are going to handle when there's going to be a very high scale, or when we have to consider cost. We always will have to think about horizontal and vertical scales, scaling, and how to improve the system. And there'll be n number of questions arising. And a solution that recently that has been very useful in most of our projects is using serverless architecture, right? Where you have something like AWS Lambda, which will be along with API Gateway, SQS, provide you a very good option to deploy your application, which will which will be scaling depending on the cost, and also the cost will also be maintainable. The problem here is Lambdas are basically functions. If you have worked on Lambda, we have Lambda functions that we define, and then we have API gateways which will be connecting it so that we can call it from the outer world, and also we have SQS, which is going to be the queue. And using a proper event-driven architecture, we can create very good applications. And we even have good CloudWatch logs, and we have a very beautiful metrics table that we'll get for individual things in AWS. But now the question is, Django is a complete framework, not just functions, right? And AWS Lambda is a completely different setup. How do we handle both these things? And this is what we found as a really good solution. We have something called SAPA. SAPA is actually something that connects between AWS Lambda and your Django project. So it's a very simple process where you create your application, you create a SAPA settings file, a SAPA settings.json file. It's just like you create a file in Heroku to give your settings, right? And in this SAPA settings, you can provide all the information about your AWS settings, and also the events that you want to trigger, all those information. And SAPA will be acting as a CLI tool, which will actually help you to, it's a basic command, like a SAPA deploy your environment. And once you do that, SAPA will create everything that is required for you, and you'll get a URL which you can use for your application, which means that your Django project will be zipped, and it will be uploaded as an AWS into AWS Lambda, and AWS Lambda will be created. It will also create API gateway for you, and it will also have the connection between SQS and the Lambda. And even in case of SQS Lambda connection, that is the event-driven architecture, you don't have to create individual individual functions. SAPA will help you in a way where you just have to create a function in your Django project, and we can just have a basic connection using the SAPA. And using this SAPA, it will whenever there's a new item in the SQS and the corresponding trigger that has to be happened, that will be done by the SAPA itself. So we have been using this AWS Lambda plus SAPA plus Django in a big project, and we found it really useful in terms of load that it can handle, and in terms of cost that we have. And it's always worth a try to do something in this kind of an environment where you can actually find the usage and get an input and output, like where we are and how much you can actually try it out. So I will highly recommend you guys to go through SAPA and do your projects and see how AWS Lambda can help you. And I just wanted to give you an introduction about these things, and so that some of you who are still confused about how to use your application will get an idea about this. And yeah, basically that's it from my part. Thank you for giving the opportunity.